The next topic that we are going to discuss here is system software and application software. So what is a software? Softwares are a platform for the user to interact with the computer. Very simple. We have Android is an operating system in a mobile. Android is an operating system. Versions of Android is there. Oxygen 11, latest one, Oxygen 11 is there. or in the case of Windows, Windows 10 is there. Ubuntu is there. Linux is there. So n number of operating systems are there. Mac OS is there for Apple users, iPhone users. Likewise, n number of operating systems are there. So then softwares are there. What's the difference between operating system and the software? Operating system is an interface between user and the hardware or a computer. Okay, we can't directly communicate to the machines. Okay, listen, CPU, I need this one. We can't say directly, or we can't directly speak to the computer. We need an interface. So that interface is operating system. Whether it is a mobile phone or a laptop or a computer, we need such kind of interface to communicate. So operating system is such an interface to communicate for the user to the machines. Then what is software? Again, operating systems has limitations that it has developed for a generic purpose, that the users just want to interact with the computer. If you want to do a specific operations, if you need to perform a specific operation, like if you want to communicate with the social setup, like social media, then you need a platform, a special platform. Such kind of platforms are, example, YouTube, then Facebook. So a separate platform is there is needed, rather than the facilities available in operating system is not sufficient to communicate for you people to a group of people or a society. So in this case, we need a separate platform, a special platform, and to communicate through that platform will be more easier or more convenient for you people to interact. In such a case, we need softwares. So such kind of softwares are Google. In Google Play, you are installing a number of softwares, like Facebook, there is a software, YouTube, there is a software. So what you are doing is, you are installing those softwares in an operating system so that you can communicate with that software to the society. Likewise, so operating system is there, softwares are there. And again, softwares are of two types. One is system software, another one is application software. So system softwares, we are going to discuss about the difference between system software and an application software. System software is a type of a software which is an interface between application software and the system. So I told you that Facebook is the application software. You need to communicate the Facebook facility with the device first. Initially, you have to communicate with the device. Then only you are going to interact with the people who are staying outside that network or in the internet. So for that, you need system software. So first, this Facebook is a tool, and that tool has to communicate with your machine. So the machine has to perform. If you are saying that I like this particular video, you are saying that you are sending a friend request. Okay, what you are doing is, you are just clicking on that request or suggestions or whatever it is available on the Facebook. First, initially, what the Facebook software is doing is, it is first communicate with the machine that you are using, whether it is a computer or a laptop or a mobile phone. Initially, it has to communicate with the machine, and machine should have the facility to communicate with the internet. Okay, it may be a Wi-Fi or a data provider facility or whatever it may be. So the machine has to support. So first step is to initially convert that software or communicate that software to the machine. Then only that further communication will happen. So we need a software for that, to support the application software. So system software is a type of a software which is the interface between application software and system. Second one, application software. It's a type of a software which runs as per the user request. I told you, Facebook, YouTube, then Amazon, or whatever it may be. N number of application softwares are there. It runs on the platform which is provided by the system software. Okay. The languages used for developing these softwares are, first one, system softwares are developed in low-level languages because it is just want to it is used to communicate with the machine. So if you are going to communicate with the machine, then you need a low-level language which is more compatible with the system hardware in order to interact with. Okay. The second one is application software. Application softwares are developed either in all the in, developed in the high-level languages like C, C++, Java, .NET, etc. Used to develop as they are developed in some specific purpose only. Okay. Then usage. System softwares is used by operating operating computers hardware. Application softwares are software is used by user to perform a specific task. The YouTube to software is used to perform a specific task in the sense it just want to play the video. Okay, it's a specific task. So the application softwares like Facebook used to interact with the people who are available in the internet. Okay. YouTube is to play the video, or a set of videos are there. We want to play whatever we need, so it's a specific task is there for each and every application softwares. Installation, system software are installed on the computer when operating systems is installed. Okay, why? The system software is really depend on the operating system. Once the operating system is installed on the computer, for example, via installing the Android OS Oxygen 11 installing on your device, at the same time the system software is also installed. Application softwares are installed according to the user requirements. So some people may not need the Facebook, they need only the LinkedIn. Some people they need only Flipkart, okay, rather than using other marketing softwares. Likewise, based on the user requirements, this installation may happen. User interaction. System softwares are specific to system hardware, so less or no user interaction available in case of system software. We already discussed, user interaction is very less. But in the case of application software, users can interact with it as user interface is available in this case. So users can directly interact. So what their intention is to communicate with the for example, if it's a banking software, the user want to communicate with the bank. For example, I need to transfer a particular amount to that particular person. So a specific purpose is there. So user interaction in application software is high. Users can interact with it as user interface is available in this case. Dependency, system software can run independently. It provides platform for running application software. Application softwares can't run independently. The example is the Android softwares are specifically for the Android users, not for the Mac users. For Mac users, they have to separately download that tool and install. So its application softwares are dependent on this operating system. That is the thing that we are discussing here. System softwares can run independently. It provides platform for running application software. But application software can't run independently. They can run without the presence of the system software. For example, the softwares made for Windows is not suitable for Linux. Very simple. The example for system softwares are compilers, assembler, debugger, drivers, etc. Application softwares are word processor, web browsers, media players, etc. Hope you all understand the concepts. Thank you for watching the video. We will see the next video. Okay, in the next classes. Okay, thank you.